How you doing out there, y'all? Welcome to another episode of The Tea with Meal Spouse Conversations. I am Sybil, the host here, and we are ready to talk about friendships and conversations. Hence the name, Meal Spouse Conversations. Y'all supposed to laugh. Let me go ahead and bring the rest of the team on board, and we're going to get this show started. Oh, Tiana wanted to say something too, y'all. You know what? Actually, we're not about to get this show started, because y'all know what I forgot to do? Y'all know what I forgot?
What?
I forgot our intro commercial. So let me back up and play that real quick. I know, Tiana. I know. Y'all, this is live TV. All right. Yes, I'm calling it TV. Because we're going to make it on TV one day, y'all. We're going to be there. Hold on. Welcome to The Tea by Meal Spouse Conversations. Let's meet the conversation starters. We have Sybil Jones, our Navy spouse and CEO. Up next, we have Grace Romo representing Marine Spouses. And our very own, I got a resource for that, Miss Anna Bruner, our Navy spouse. And our veteran and Navy spouse, Miss Nye Cruz. And Air Force, Miss Lori Waddell. And our Army National Guard spouse, Ms. Julie Provost. We want to give a special thanks to our sponsors, USAA and Make Me Awesome, for making this happen this year. And now, let's get ready to spill the tea. We're back. All right, let's go ahead and dive into this week's topic. Friendships and conversations. How important is friendship to you? Miss Anna, how important is a friendship to you? I think Miss Anna is frozen in time. That's all right. Let's go ahead and ask Miss Julie.
Oh, I think they're very important to getting through life and making memories and having fun and just everything. Like the good and the bad, you know?
Yes. Yes. Because, hey, look, I know my friends have been there with me through the good, the bad, and the ugly. Tiana is not my friend, y'all. She is not my friend, but she has a lot to say about conversations.
Sure does.
All right, Anna, you're back. Nope, she's not back. All right, Grace, I'm just going to ask you. You can give me a three-word answer because I know your throat's a little sore tonight.
Yeah, I think friendships are very important, and I somewhat think that just conversation in general is more important because as military spouses, you can't always build friendships right away. So they good both point. Go hand in hand, but conversations first. That was more than three words.
But those are great three words. But yes, just really a simple conversation, a simple hello, a smile, a how are you doing, and a You start a conversation. And I think a lot of times as military spouses, we get so hung up on looking for that new bestie. Nah, sometimes, yo, you're not going to find your bestie, but you might find yourself an acquaintance or a hoe. And and let me explain what I mean by that. When we move every couple of years, we want to go out sightseeing. We want to go out to eat, go buy shoes. Hey, you don't have to be best friends with this individual, but you have some things in common. So hang out with them. Now, I'm going to behave myself. I'm not going to go off. Look, if y'all want to talk about that, y'all have to come and join us for the conversation, the behind the scenes. And I will break down what I mean by a whole acquaintance and a good, good girlfriend when it comes to friendships. Anna, do you have anything to say? Are you still frozen in time?
She's in another dimension, I'm afraid.
She is. All right, so let me ask you guys this question. Do you think that social media has made it more convenient to build friendships, or do you think it has hindered it some?
I think overall it's made it more convenient. It's easier to stay in touch with people that otherwise you may have otherwise lost touch with. Like, I mean, there's people that I was friends with years back that if it wasn't for social media, they would have just, you know, gone into the memories. You know, but now
they didn't remember that mention, like Anna.
Yeah, just another dimension, right? But now, like, I can comment on their stuff. They can comment on my stuff. I can see like what they're doing, what their kids are doing. Like, I'm more a part of their life. When otherwise, you know, because you simply can't keep in touch with everyone in the sense of like calling all the time and like, you know, it's just not possible. So social media is a easy way to kind of stay connected to people that you probably otherwise wouldn't have, which on the other hand could be a bad thing, right? Like, there are people that maybe it would be better if we were no longer seeing what they were doing, but
that's when you just move them to that other friend list.
right. We do have control over what we see on our news feeds, so
yes. But also with technology, I think, especially with the military life, you're able to meet people and build some form of relationship before you even arrive at the duty station.
Right.
Or in our case, we have talked to one another. I talked to Julie for 3 years online? Before we
finally met. Over 3 years now. Over 3 years.
Yes. And the same with Grace. I didn't know Grace. I met Grace one time in person, but our conversations are here at Mill Spouse Conversations and Slack with voice messages. And lovely Anna, we met back in Virginia and we have stayed in touch through social media.
Yeah, I think social media makes conversation more fluid. It gives it easy access. You know, you can hop on, say something, hop on later, say something. You don't have to have that constant like phone call, FaceTime, whatever. I would say though, I think it makes friendships a little more difficult because people are so used to just being on social media, or it gives them that out, right? You can make plans on Facebook or on Messenger or on whatever. Hey, let's meet, blah, blah, blah. They're like, yeah. You never see them in person, you know? Why? Because they're already receiving everything they need from you online. So they're not really needing that person up front, you know? So I think it can go both ways. It can create relationships, but it can also make it really hard when there's just constant access.
Yes. And as one of the viewers just commented, I flashed it up a few minutes ago, but I'll put it back up. In person or on the phone convo is so important to stay truly connected. Yes. And look, I also think, I know a lot of people hate Zoom, but I love Zoom because I can hop on a face-to-face with you. We can chat, catch up, and yo, we're golden. It is golden. Yeah. But I think it's great to be able to hear a person's voice as well. Because as Grace said, on social media, you can make plans. And then if the individual cancels, you don't hear their tone of why they canceled on you. And I'm not going to lie, I'm mad. I'm a little salty. Whereas if we have a conversation or even just sit across the table, get with your friends that are in your area, go out for coffee, go out for lunch.
I think, yeah, a lot of times you have to make yourself do it. If, especially if you get so busy or you have kids and you're exhausted, that's usually my barrier, is just being that exhausted and not enough time. But I found, even with you, Sybil, up in Northern Virginia, where you just make yourself do it, you make the plan, you go do it, and you always feel so much better after meeting up in person or even just on the phone and the Zooms. It really is so much better.
So much better. Oh, Angela has a comment. Let me flash this up here. Y'all see it? It's easier to stay in touch with people and connect with new people, but it's a problem because people turn to the keyboard instead of actually talking. Yes. And then on social media, with conversation on social media, you get your keyboard warriors that you're like, hey, yo, would you say that to me if we were face to face?
A lot of people say things they would never say to people in person.
Yes.
And it's probably ruining our society, to be honest.
But. Yes. Because, you know, being in the military community and being on different military spouse groups, you know, if there's a problem in the neighborhood, and this is true even in civilian world, right? People go to the keyboard and they want to post in the Facebook groups instead of walking out their front door and knocking on their neighbor's door because they're afraid to have a conversation. Like, just
it's like when we live in this society where people are taking pictures of other people, just like going for a walk or out with their family or walking by their house. And it's just like, like, it just creates this kind of weird environment where it's like, do I want to talk to these people? Like, I don't think that I do, because it's like, what are they saying? What are they doing? What are they posting? You know, like, I don't know. It's just a weird thing.
It's very weird. Extremely weird. But we're going to come back and talk more about friendships and what we look for in friendships. But we're going to go to one of our new segments right now. Bear with me as I make this transition. Y'all, I am learning. It's going to be smooth as butter one of these days. All right, folks. Here we go. 1 second.
You mean to tell me there ain't no way?
Y'all, my hair was done. My makeup was done. Look at me today. Oh, my goodness.
Anywho, fabulous.
Thank you. All right. So my tip, my hack, my there ain't no way for today is for my friends who BCS all the time, or people who want to decorate and they don't want to wait for their significant others to help them put stuff on, or sorry, husband, if you're watching, but if he puts them crooked and you have to do it yourself, this is for you. Okay. So you're going to get your item that you want to hang. And I'm using an example of something that has two sides to hang on. You can use it for anything that has any pieces, whether it's like a hook or a string, whatever you want. And I know I myself struggle with like, okay, how far apart? Or, you know, I'm up on a ladder or stepping on a bed or my kid's toys to hang something. And like, it looks even, but it's totally not. So you're going to get your item you're going to hang. You're going to get some painter's tape and a marker. Have you seen this before? You seen this hack?
No. Okay. And I need this because I can't hang a thing.
Yeah. So you're going to get your tape. Okay. I'm doing this in the reflection, so bear with me. But you're going to put the tape over and across your holes. And then you're going to mark, okay, this is really harsh in the reflection. You're going to mark where the lines are for your holes.
Oh, this is brilliant.
And then you're going to rip your tape. Ow, on my hair. And then you're going to put this on your wall and you're just going to nail the holes in there. The nail for the holes. Nail the nails into here. And then you just rip the tape off and then hang it on. And you have the exact measurement from one side to the other. And then you can get a level and stick it on top of here. You know, right, just put it right on top to make sure it's leveled. You can do like the laser ones, whatever you want to do. But this will get you your width so you're not like constantly moving them and making all kinds of holes in your wall. So yeah, that's my There Ain't No Way. And it took me a really long time to figure that out. But I have all my paintings on the wall now, as you can see.
That is brilliant. Because I don't hang anything because it's always it's like lopsided like this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, mine's either lopsided or like I put the nail too far out, like from the other side. I'm like, it's about this big, you know, and I'm always missing it. And then I get frustrated. I'm like, oh, whatever, just put it on like this. But this way it makes it so easy. And then if you're like me and you hate wasting stuff, this is a Lori tip. You can continue using your piece for like smaller pieces. Just put it back on top and then mark it with a different color. If you want it to.
Makes sense.
So yeah, it's like you're running out and you don't have enough. Just reuse it. Just stick it back on and do it. Oh, girl, me too. Magnets and pins and poster stickers. That's me.
Yes,
because it's that or it's never going up. You just got to get it, put it up.
Right.
Yes, because look, my walls are bare. I don't have patience, and everything is always. And my husband's like, Sybil, I'm like, dude, you do it.
Yeah, so show us all your pictures you put up and come hang out with us next week.
Oh, hold on. I'm reading these comments over here. Oh, so we have a man tip. Is that what that says? They're coming through a little slowly on mine. Oh, bravo, that's man trick 101. You are the first lady I've seen do this trick as well. Ah, who is this Facebook user? Tell us your name.
I am curious. I'm gonna have to bring some more man tricks.
Right. Whoever you are, you know, the ladies
are called a woman.
No, that's the second time I've been called lady today. That's interesting.
Lady. Oh, okay. This is okay. You know what? Let's talk about you, Tony Tone. No, I'm gonna be nice to you. I'm gonna be nice, but I am going to tell the story about how Tony and I met. We met, 2023? Yeah, it's been that long ago.
2023, that's such a long time ago.
I mean, did I say 2023?
Minutes.
2003, we met 2003.
Okay, that makes more sense for a long time ago.
Yes. We met in Kings Bay, Georgia, and his wife and I, we became really great friends. She was my first male spouse friend, so much that we became sisters. She helped me decorate, Grace, because I could not decorate at all. She talked so bad about me. She's like, girl. I was like, I'm trying. Leave me alone. But we became friends. We remained friends for years. And she passed away like seven years ago. And I still talk about memories and friendships. I have very fond memories of her. Going out to eat, we used to go out all the time. When the boat would go out to sea, we were eating. Well, she helped me. She taught me how to hang stuff up, Tony. Now, but anywho, let me go back and focus. All right, we're going to go ahead and pay some bills and go to this commercial break. And we will be right back and finish this conversation. Alrighty, folks. Alrighty. Yeah. Yay. Say yay. Y'all, I'm trying to buy a little time as I'm back here trying to produce and talk. And I'm struggling today. I need a nap. USAA is, am I muted?
Now we can hear you.
Oh, okay. I'm over here talking like that. And in case you guys didn't know, USAA is our Convolicious sponsor. They are the ones who are making this all possible. So give a super shout out. Thank you to USAA. Put that in the comments. Say thank you, USAA, for supporting Meal Spouse Conversations. Put it in the comments now. Yes, I'm telling you what to do. Because that's what friends are for. Friends tell you what to do.
They do.
Now, Anna, I'm going to turn this to you because you hosted our Florida event, in-person event on April 1st. Tell us about the scene there and the friendships that were made.
So, yeah, actually, a couple of the spouses there were either fairly new spouses or fairly new to the area, and they wanted to meet new people. And so it was great for them to come out and see us in person and just be face to face. Like, you know, just sitting there and with them face to face and chatting and.
There she goes, back to the other dimension again. You never know
when she'll come in and pop out. Hey, y'all, look. Meal Spouse Conversations, we are real. We are real. We are relatable. We are raw. What you see is what you get, right? We're having technical difficulties, but you know what? In real life, we have technical difficulties too. Just saying. Some of us a little more than others, but hey, we are everyday spouses. We show up as we are, even in another dimension. And we like to talk with you. We don't talk at you. We want to talk with you. So as Anna makes her way back here, she will tell us about the Florida event. But I will tell you guys this. We have a virtual event every month where you come and chat with us. My dog is pacing. She best not pee in my floor. But anywho, our virtual events are private. They are not streamed live. What you see now is our talk show. But our virtual events, they're done via Zoom. We keep them intimate. And they are engaging. So as I said, you get to talk with us. And we have a good time. We actually have an event coming up on the 28th of this month. And it's called Laundry Sip. What is it? Laundry and Sip. Yes, y'all. We're going to sip on our water. I'm drinking water because I'll be hot. Because I'm having hot flashes. But whatever your beverage of choice is. And we're going to chat with one another and have some conversation. Because who here loves to talk while they're doing chores.
Julie said no.
Do not talk to me. I have my headphones on. I'm doing my chores. Don't talk to me.
Nope. I hop on FaceTime to get my chores done.
Nope. Don't talk to me.
I bring that phone everywhere. You see every mess, every room I'm in. You see everything.
Yes.
I don't even want my kids to talk to me when I have my earbuds in.
Oh, that's different, Julie. I don't want my kids to talk to me either. But I'll talk to a friend or someone, an adult.
Yes. And oh, Tony will tell you this if he remembers. Me and his wife, we would get on the phone. We're cleaning. She's cleaning. I'm cleaning. But we kept the house clean, y'all. We'd be talking for 5 hours. But the house was clean. Okay, I'm lying. Sometimes nothing got accomplished because we were having too much fun. But hey, it's all good. And I talk to Angela a lot when I'm cleaning too. Yes, Angela. You were in the bathroom with me the other day. I was scrubbing that toilet after I dropped those kids off at the pool. Girl, I had to drop them kids off at the pool. And I had to get in there and scrub that toilet because... Y'all, yes, I'm talking about poop. My kids that I dropped off at the pool was poop. Oh, okay, so Anna. This is Anna. Since my internet doesn't like me, I will comment here. The number one comment received at the in-person event was that they love the unscripted in-person conversation and, of course, the tea and donuts. Yes, y'all, at our in-person events, we feed you. We meet up, have some boba tea, some donuts, maybe some burgers, pizza, wings, and beer. That's what we did in San Diego. We had pizza, beer, and wings. And guess who paid for it? New Spouse Conversations. You just have to sign up and show up. That's all. Don't be scared of us. We don't bite. But let me go back to the virtual event on the 28th. Sign up, go to our website, newspouseconversations.com, click on the event link, register. We are charging a fee for that, but guess what? You can pay $1. Just a dollar. That's all. Help support us. We're the new kids on the block, but we want to take up the entire street. Okay? We don't want just a block. We actually want the world. Okay, let me focus because y'all know. I'm rogue, y'all. I am rogue. Well, Anna, can you come back on screen, please? All right, I'm going to ask these two ladies this question. What do you look for in a friendship? What's important to you in a friendship?
Being able to connect over something, have something in common that you can talk about or relate to each other. And just like the general vibe, I guess. Like, how's that? How's the vibe? Like, are we vibing or are we not?
You know. Are we?
I'm with Julie. I definitely look for that vibe. That's a really good way to put it, because, and especially I think too, as a mom, if y'all aren't like on the same playing field of like parenthood and how you parent and things that you think are okay, I can kind of start to rock the friendship a little bit, or just maybe not even turn into a friendship. And at first, like before my littles, like it was whatever, like everybody was vibing totally fine. And now I'm very particular because I parent a certain way. And not that I'm against anybody parenting a different way, but I want my kids to make sure they're staying in the realm that I want them to stay in, and, you know, vice versa for the other parent. But I also think too, someone who's in the same stage of life as I am, because I mean, people who don't have kids can go out all the time. They don't have to get a sitter. They don't have as many, like, you know, things to stop them from doing stuff. And so I try to find people that are in the same stage. That way we can do more together. We can relate more, you know, all those type of things. And oh yeah, connection, honesty, and commitment. Yeah. It's like a relationship, y'all. Friendships are like a relationship. 100%.
Yeah, commitment is important too, because it's like, you know, you can, there's been people that I've connected with really well, but like, there's no commitment there. So it just, I'd love to be friends with them, but it's just not going to work because there's no, and you know, sometimes it's just because of life. You know, it's not necessarily somebody like, being doing something wrong. It's just, you know, sometimes stages of life, it just, you can't make time for it, or they can't make time for it. It just, it's not the right, the timing's off.
The priorities are different for each person.
Yeah. So it doesn't work. Whereas if you met maybe 5 years down the road, maybe it would have worked, but, and that's just life. And you just kind of have to roll with it because it's the way it is.
And it's okay to let friendships go.
It's true.
Because I think a lot of times we get stuck and we feel like we have to remain friends with someone. And no.
And you really don't. Like,
if the vibe isn't there.
Yeah. And you can gotta go. Like, have really good feelings towards people that are no longer in your life. Like, oh, they were a part of my life 5 years ago. Like, they were so special to me, and I will always cherish those moments. And, you know, I think of them all the time, but it's just not gonna work right now. So,
and that's where the importance of conversation comes in as well for me, right? Mm-hmm. That communication with that friend, because if you're no longer my good girlfriend, I'm gonna have to explain to you that you have been demoted to one of my
hosts. And that's gonna be awkward. You are now a hoe.
You only get to come around me when we going shoe shopping. That's it. That's it. Yes, Liz. Yes. Friendships for different seasons.
Yes. So true. So true.
And it is okay. And I try to teach that to my kids. Do you guys talk to your kids about friendship?
Mine are too little right now.
Okay.
Oh. Okay. Max, here comes Tiana. She's like, oh, there's a toy. Anna, come back. So let me ask you this question. See, I have my notes written down. Y'all, this is real. I can't read what I wrote because it was a bunch of chicken scratch because I was like, ah. How do you maintain a long distance friendship? Because as military spouses, we're constantly moving. And I know we say social media, but how important is it for you to maintain that relationship when you leave said duty station?
I'll only maintain it for as long as it's serving a purpose. So if it's just dying off and I'm the only one communicating and they're not showing that commitment, that honesty, that stuff, then I'm just not going to nurture it anymore. And that's happened. And it's unfortunate because you have like that good, good friend that you're leaving and you want to take it. And it does last for a while. But when you aren't in person, when you aren't having those face-to-face conversations, you're not doing things together, it does tend to slow down a little bit. And it could just be, you know, you just call every once in a while and stuff. But to me, if we went from this like really big thing and then it's just very, very minimal and I'm showing the effort, it's just not serving anymore. And you kind of just let it go.
Yeah, I think it's rare to stay as connected as you were in person. I think it takes a lot from both sides. And again, like I said before, like sometimes just life gets in the way and it's just hard to maintain. And so I haven't moved in a very long time, but I live near Fort Campbell. So I've had a lot of people move away from me. And I think like these days I'm more like, okay, that's fine. I understand it's going to be different and we'll just see what happens. But I don't put a lot of stock into, oh, it's going to be exactly the same and we're going to talk every day and everything. Cause that's really, it's really rare in my experience. And I think, you know, it's one of those things like you're moving, they're moving on, you're moving on, whoever's moving is moving on. And, you know, it just can't be the same. It just can't be.
It's different. Yeah. And that is fine. Mm-hmm. That is perfectly fine. All right. We're going to have a new segment. We're going to play a game. I wanted Anna to come back so she can be part of this game. Come on, Anna. But stay tuned because we are going to talk more about friendship and conversation. All right. Give me 1 second, folks. We're going to get this on and popping. Y'all can say something. Hold on. Oh, actually, I think my husband got out of. No. Oh, he did. Hold on. Can y'all hear me talking?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm just going to put a little music in the background.
This is going to be funny. I feel like I know enough, but I don't know. If I really do.
Mess up with like branch specific ones.
Oh yeah. I know. Sybil's going to throw up some Navy stuff. I don't know that.
This is my jam, y'all. All right. Are y'all ready?
Mm-hmm. Ready.
Who knows this song? Can you name this tune? All right. So we have a game show called Name the Military Term or Acronym. Whoop, whoop. Hold on. So we were originally supposed to have a contest to see who was going to make it on the show. But
we win for Anna being here.
Yes, Julie! All right. Are y'all ready?
Ready.
So let me tell you the rules. You have 30 seconds. I forgot the rules. Oh, Lord Jesus. I'm going to put the next slide up. It's going to have the acronym. And if you think you know the answer, raise your hand. You can take the guess or you can ask for someone in the audience to help you. And if the person you select from the audience, because audience, you need to comment and say, I know it, say something. So they can select the person they want to help. And if you get it right, your teammate will receive some Meal Spouse Conversations goodies because, you know, we like to celebrate winners and losers, but but winners. All right, here we go. Name that military term or acronym, MSC. What does it mean? Oh, Grace, okay.
See, you think you know Grace? Conversations. Yeah. It's C, military spouse conversation.
C, military spouse conversation. Final answer? Do you final want to answer. Ask an audience member?
No one raised their hand. Final no one answer. Wants to be my teammate.
So, Julie.
Yes.
Okay. Julie, do you agree? You have a chance to steal this.
No, this is definitely military. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, okay. Military spouse.
Military. Oh. He was a man.
Trick does. Trick does.
What is a military
term? I told you she was going to put some Navy stuff up. That is not fair, Sybil.
Yeah, I don't even know what's a military.
That is not a good one. Whatever. You know, I kind of debated, but I was like, she's not going to do that to us. She's not going to throw some Navy stuff out there. What? Redo. We need a redo.
Hey, you know. You know. So the Military Sea Lift Command, let me get this back so we're all on the screen. It is an organization that controls the replenishment and military transport ships of the United States Navy. But let me ask you this question. If anyone want to take a guess, anyone in the audience? Is this an active duty command or most of the employees civilian?
Facebook user raised their hand.
I cannot see the screen. Oh, what does the Facebook user say?
They said hi with a hand. It's both. Oh. They said it's both.
I cannot see the comments. Okay. Oh, so we had C. Oh, we had some folks who took a guess. Okay. It's both. Well, that is true. It is. So you're saying it's both for active duty and civilian?
Yeah, I think that's what they're saying.
Okay. Well, it is. They employ, most of their employees are not active duty, but MSC plays a critical role in support of our nation's defense, and 40% of the workforce is prior military. You can learn more about them on the blog, on our blog, as a matter of fact. So go to millspouseconversations.com.
Yeah. So do we have another acronym? I want to redeem myself.
All right, we got you.
Do not. I just day, have Julie. One day. But you know what? We're going to play this game every week.
There's okay, next time we got it.
All right.
Every week.
You won't be able to trick us next time. You're smarter.
I'm going to have to look up some Navy terms.
I mean, you know, I'm going to throw some Marine terms out there.
I mean, I feel like I would have gotten any branch except Navy, to be honest. I know nothing about the Navy.
Well, wait a minute, Grace, because the Marines and Navy are way more
right, racist. But my husband does nothing compared to that, like, at all. His job would be closer to, like, other branches than Navy. So, and then, like, all our family that are active duty, they're all everything except Navy. So, there's that, too.
So let me ask you guys about this, about your friendships across the branches. Do y'all have friends that are in other branches?
Yes.
Besides me, Julie.
yes. I think so.
I don't think
so. What about
so.
You, Grace?
I don't think so.
Well, I have now that we're Army National Guard, I do know a lot of Army spouses. But I don't really know very many National Guard spouses, to be honest.
Do you find it hard to make friends across the branches?
Well, that's an interesting question, because here's the thing. Where I live, you're an Army spouse. If you're a military spouse, you're an Army spouse. So,
see, not I. My husband's Marine Corps, and we're on an Army, in an Army area. He's not on an Army base, but we're in an Army area.
Yeah, I think, like, wherever you are physically located, might have something to do with who you meet in your daily life.
Very true. That is very, very true.
Like here, it's just Army. But like other places, like San Diego, you're going to have the different.
Okay, lied. I do have people in other branches. I was just thinking about them and who their spouse. We don't talk about the spouse's jobs, y'all. So I'm just like, they're friends.
So, Grace, that brings an interesting question. When you meet another spouse, how do you introduce yourself?
With my name and then I'm a mom. No, but really, I'm like, hi, I'm Grace. And then whatever response we get from that, we kind of go from there. And I'll be like, oh, yeah, I have two kids. You know, trying to lay the basis of what my life looks like, all the chaos, to make sure we could vibe. And then kind of go from there. But I definitely don't introduce, like, oh, I'm a Marine Corps spouse, or, oh, this is what my husband does. Like, I try to stay as far away from that as possible. Like, no rank talk, no, none of that. Unless the other person brings it up, that's when we'll dive into that. But me personally, I don't bring any of that into the conversation.
What is M Day, Rebecca?
I don't even know what that is. Am I supposed to know?
So wait, you're supposed to know this. Now, I will say I've met, so I've had an Air Force spouse friend, and that was weird at first.
The one we get
my neighbor. And I was like, because I didn't know what she was talking about. But I learned, right? Like, that opened up so much conversation. Because, hey, we came from different walks of military life. Oh, M-Day. See, I was thinking that too. Marine Day? The 1 week in a month. Drill, okay.
Yeah, that's like my husband. It's the 1 week in a month type of guard member.
And I've learned a lot about the guard from having conversation with Julie. Because remember, Julie, when I told you, I was like, all I know about the guard is, I knew about the National Guard, what's the building called? The National Guard Armory.
Armory, yeah.
And I was like, oh, I remember going to dances and Christmas parties there. I didn't know. I really didn't. But Julie schooled me. I was like, oh, okay. But again, that's having conversation.
Right.
And that's what we are about here at Mill Spouse Conversation. During our show, and especially our events. Especially our events. We come behind the scenes. We have a topic and we talk. You get to talk during those events. You don't just sit and listen to me ramble. You get to talk. You can ask your questions, share your experience, laugh with us, cry with us. Because sometimes, yeah, I've cried. I'm going to cry on the 28th because I know Grace is going to make me throw my socks away. Oh, my holy socks. I just want to keep them. Y'all, we're going to fold laundry. That's what we're going to do. We're going to sip on our beverages, fold some laundry, and chat. Have a good time.
Karen was talking about when you meet a non-military friend and you're the first military wife they're friends with. And let me tell you, they have like a million questions and like, so many preconceived ideas about what your life
is. Is Army wives real?
Yeah.
Real life?
It's quite entertaining, to be honest, to see that outside perspective, what people have on your life. And, you know, it's very interesting.
Yes. And being Navy, a lot of people are familiar with Army and Marine. So when they talk to me about Navy life, I'm like, no, my husband's on a ship. Like, he just floats in the middle of the ocean. Right. And they're like, oh, they don't realize that they are literally on a ship.
When I think Navy, I think people swimming in the ocean for some reason.
What? Well, funny. Rebecca, you know what? We're going to have a National Guard social. We'll do a virtual social hour. And hey, how about that?
That's cool.
Who are you, Angela? Who are you asking about where, who's located? Who?
I think Rebecca, because she wants a friend.
Oh.
No, I think it's IYG Real Estate Solutions.
Oh, you're in Norfolk. You know what?
Sometimes they do swim in the ocean. See?
Yes, they do. They do. But you know what? My Navy, my new Navy friend is going to get me. We have never been stationed in Norfolk. Like, Norfolk is a big Navy stop. We have never been to Norfolk. I'm like, please, I don't want to go to Norfolk.
Uh-oh, Sybil, you just jinxed yourself. Never say, I never want to go to, because they are always listening.
Her name is Ingrid. Hi, Ingrid.
Hi, Ingrid. Oh, she's like, I don't know why my name doesn't change. It's okay. It's okay. We'll just call you IYG Real Estate Solutions. All right, ladies. Is there anything else? Am I missing anything?
I don't think so. Oh. Just a reminder to do our event next week.
Yes. Oh, and we have new swag.
Oh,
that's or not swag. New merch. Yes. Pop socket. Stick it on your phone. It says Meals Boss Conversations, established when I said I do. Ha ha ha. And this is in our Amazon store. So go shop. Support. Yes, y'all. I said it. I said it. And I'll say it again. No, but what I will say is be sure to come join us for our virtual event on the 28th. Let me put it up here real quick. Y'all, I am a hot mess today. A hot mess. I'm a hot mess every day. But just a little extra today. Grace is like, nah, you always a hot mess.
I didn't say anything.
Let me find the registration. Here you go. You can find us right there, MealSpouseConversations.com/Military Spouse Social Hours. Or just go to MealSpouseConversations.com, click on events, voila. Or go to Eventbrite, because that is where you will register. And come on and join us. What you see is what you get. We just want to talk with you, y'all. We want to have conversation and build friendship. Because I do believe in the power of friendship across the miles. We have the tea room. You just have to come in, pull out your seat, or sit on the couch and join us, and watch Grace tell me to throw my socks away because they have holes. These don't have holes.
Oh, I found holes in my socks yesterday, and the first thing I thought of was Sybil. Just saying.
Whatever.
But they went in the trash right away. I'll say that. Sybil. Not on my feet.
So... Grace, let me tell you what happened to me the other day. I put on these socks. I had a hole, like the entire heel of the sock was out. And I was going to a doctor's appointment, but I wasn't thinking I was going to have to take my shoes off. Uh-oh.
That's a good one. That's a good one. The universe was telling you, throw them away.
It's all good. It's all good. All right, folks. Thank you for tuning in. Be sure to get always a hot mess. I'll say it for, oh, no. Mm-hmm. Oh, wait a minute. Angel said, because you didn't get to talk to me much today. That's what happened. Oh, you know what, guys? This is something else that we offer. Every second and fourth Wednesday, we have midweek check-ins, where again, you get to come via Zoom and you get to chat with me just to, how are you? Because we all need to hear the words, how are you? And I don't talk, I am your friend and I listen. Unless you want me to say something back to you. But no, seriously, like I'm for real with that. Sometimes we just need to have someone say, how are you? Mm-hmm. And just have someone to listen. Someone you can relate with. Hey, it's all good. Why y'all looking at me like that? Y'all just looking at me?
We were just listening. We were being quiet.
See? I'm paranoid. Did I do all the shout outs and things that we need? I think so. How many? I'm buying time as I'm trying to find y'all. I'm over here producing and talking. So how many of you are going to join us on the 28th? Go RSVP right now. It's going to be fun. And we're going to have some giveaways too, y'all. Look. And that giveaway is going to involve some food. I'm not coming to your house to cook it.
That'd be kind of awkward.
And be sure to keep an eye out for our in-person events, because we do have some happening in San Diego, California, Texas, and Jacksonville. All right, so tell your friends. Tell your friends about Meals Boss Conversations, just in general. Tell them to watch the show. We stream live every first and third Thursday of the month. We have a lot of opportunities to just come and talk, and we share our life experience, and we are wild and free. Bye. Thank you.